नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जेवियंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। सो टुडे द सेशन विच वी विल डिस्कस इज द ब्रिकेटिंग मशीनरी, इट्स टाइप्स ऑफ द ब्रिकेटिंग एंड द श्रेडर्स। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द सेशन। एंड what is the briquetting, okay, and what is the concept of this? So briquetting of the biomass, it is an old age technology and one of the several techniques which are broadly classified is as densification technology. So basically the briquetting is a densification technology, means you are densifying the biomass. Okay, so this process, especially in India, it is an as old as time, cow dung cakes and fuel balls made from the coal dust, as well as hand compressed special chulhas using wood shaving are some of the prime example of this process being used in India for centuries. So even development of insulation and architectural boards or wafers or and cubes formation from forage materials are techniques of densification, though with a purpose other than utilizing the biomass for energy production. So the process of briquetting consisting of applying pressure to a mass of particles with or without binder and converting it into a compact agglomerate. Okay, so the products obtained could be in a solid geometrical form or in a form of hollow cylinders. Briquetting as a technology was invented in early 19th century. In 1923, the Pacific Coal and Wood Corporation, Los Angeles, California, USA, was already marketing wood waste briquettes. So utilization of biomass in the form of leaves, bark, wood, cakes, etc. for cooking food and warming the space in winter is known to human civilization for many centuries. The easiest and simplest way of utilizing the heat content of these biomass resources has been practiced till recent past is to burn them as it is. And however, now it has been realized that such burning of biomass has certain disadvantages, as mentioned, we will mention in the next. So everything happens for if have some positive things. If briquetting have some applications, that then it is utilized. So burning without briquetting the biomass have some disadvantages, and what are the disadvantages we will discussing here. So most of the agroforestry biomass contains high moisture, that is around 80 to 20%. Okay, and the heat generated by burning these biomasses having the high moisture biomass is consumed in the drying of biomass itself, thus depriving the quality. Okay, so the quality of heat is depriving here because the biomass contains the water and the heat which is generated by the burning. Most of the heat, or we can say there's some significant part of heat is utilized in the biomass itself by to drying the biomass. Okay, so thus it depriving the quality of your process. So most of the biomass are bulky and many of them are available in powder form, creating dust and polluting the environment also. So it is very difficult to handle, and transport and storage is also expensive because the biomass have the higher volume, with it have the air spaces in between, water content in between. So the biomass increase the volume Thus, it is difficult to handle, and transport is also difficult. Its storage is also difficult. So this is the disadvantages with the biomass. Next is the biomass has poor combustion properties. Okay, means the it will not generate too much of energy, and it will not properly burn. Okay, so it produces plenty of smoke. If it is having the water content, it will produce the smoke. So expensive and sophisticated furnace is needed to handle these type of the biomass. So complete draft and exhaust system gets blocked due to the ash carry over the emission pollutes the environment. Okay, so these are again the problems with the biomass. It will create any the environment pollution. It pollutes the environment with the emission of gases and smoke, etc. So ash may insulate the heating area, thereby reducing the energy efficiency of the system. Most of the biomass is not successfully used in simple gasifiers and the small boilers. So some of the biomass need an expensive and sophisticated equipment like the fluidized bed boilers to achieve the maximum efficiency, okay, without briquetting. Okay, so the these many disadvantages are there. So what is the solution? So solution is the briquetting. Simplest solution of all above problems that have the low bulky density, high volume, expensive handling, transportation problem, storage problems. So it lies in the solution lies in the briquetting of the biomass. The process of compaction of biomass into a product of higher density than the original raw material is known as the densification or briquetting. So it has compression ratio of approximately 7:1 to lose biomass to the to form briquettes. So the compacted fuels known as the briquettes is more or less similar to the coal and has potential to replace the conventional solid fuels and even diesel to meet the local needs of various sectors. So we have discussed the disadvantages of the unbriquetted biomass. So now we will discuss the advantages of the briquetting of biomass. So what will the benefits if you have the briquettes? So the process helps to solve the problem of loose waste residue of agriculture, forestry, and agro-industrial processing so as to check the environmental pollution. Okay, check or prevent the environmental pollution. So the process increases the net calorific value per unit volume. Understand? Per unit volume, the net calorific value will be increased by briquetting. The fuel produced is uniform in size and quality. You will get the quality fuel. And no toxic gas and sulfur emission is there, even no odor during the combustion. Okay, so densified product is easy to transport. It is easy to store because it have the lower volume than the original biomass. Bulk density of briquettes is around 1000 kg per meter cube, is higher than agro waste, that is the 50 kg per meter cube. Okay, so fire risk in loose storage is of biomass is minimized. Okay, so the process produces the high quality fuel with very low ash content, that is 2-5% compared to the 30-40% in case of the coal. So the briquettes are easy to burn, as briquettes have the lower ignition temperature compared to the coal. Okay, so their ignition temperature is also low. So it produces gas during burning, which accelerates burning efficiencies and enhances CO2 inhales CO2 and releases oxygen to the atmosphere. So what are the processing of the briquetting? So briquetting is a technological method of compressing and densifying the bulky raw material, so thereby reducing its volume weight ratio and making it usable for various purposes. So the vital requirement for briquetting formation from woody biomass is the destruction of the elasticity of the wood, so which could be done either by the previous heat treatment or by a high pressure or by the combination of both. So you need the heat and the pressure, high heat and high pressure, to break the elasticity of the wood so that it could be compressed. So there are two processes of briquetting biomasses, namely direct compaction and compaction after pyrolysis, or you can say is the carbonization, as we will discuss next. So briquetting process can be categorized into, or can be performed by, two different methods. One is the direct compaction and another is the pyrolysis, or other name of the pyrolysis is the carbonization and extrusion compaction. Okay, so these two techniques will be discussed in the next lecture, and so this is not completed in this lecture. We will study in the next lecture the techniques of the briquetting, two methods of the briquetting, and further direct compaction and the extraction, the densified material using with binder and without binder. Then we will study about the shredder, what is shredder, and what is the application of shredder, why we use in agriculture processes. And in the next, we will study about the types of densification processes, because the briquetting is one of the densification process. So except the briquetting, other processes also there, which are also included in the densification process. Okay, so if one asks that what is the briquetting, so briquetting is one of the densification process. Other processes also there, like the pelleting, cutting, extruding, rolling, compression, they are also there. So they will be discussed in the next lecture. So this was all about the briquetting. So hope you are satisfied with this detailed session. If you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will reply that. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.